Hello students, my name is Krishna Kansal from Grace Salman Fox Solution. In this tutorial 5 of this video series, we will discuss classes and objects. Dear learners, when we talk about the classes, what do you mean by the classes? We come across the lots of definitions of the classes, like class is a user-defined data type, or a class is a data structure, or we also used to say class is a template of the object. To make the concept of the class more clear, I will start from the very bottom approach, or I will start from the scratch. In our languages, if we talk about the data types, like this is a data type which is available in C language and also in a Java language. In Java language we used to say this data type as a primitive data type. These data types are used to hold the user data. Now this data type A of type integer can hold only one integer value, like we can initialize it with the integer value 20. Now if we are creating an application, in that application we want to store the 100 roll numbers of the student, then what we have to do? It will be a very bad idea to declare the 100 variables of type integer. What will be a smart solution? The smart solution will be to create an integer, or to create the array of integers and assign these all roll numbers to the array of integers. It means array is acting like a data structure which can hold the data of similar type. So when we discuss about the programming languages, we used to discuss about the what type of data a language can handle, which is known as the capability of the programming language. How capable your programming language is. Capability means what type of data your programming language can handle. Suppose if you want to model a student. Model a student means, if we take an example of a student, what type of data is associated with the student? Like roll number is one data which is associated for type student. This roll number is of type integer. Age is one type of data which is associated with the student. This age is of type integer. Name is also one of the data which is associated with the student, which you used to design with the help of char array in C language, like name. Class, in which class is it currently studying, this is one type of data. Address is one type of data which is associated with the student. In C language, what we used to do, to create a data structure which contain all these heterogeneous data type in a single name. Single name means single entity. We used to make the structures, struct, and we keep the name of the structure as a student. Now we have created one structure student. Then we used to create the variable for this structure student like s. Now this variable s is of type struct student. This variable s contains one integer, another integer, one character array, one class which you can mention in the form of an character array, one address which you can mention in the form of the character array, and you can also mention here gender. So these all variables are encapsulated under a single entity which is known as a student entity. Now if we want to make clear Okay, what do you mean by the entity? As this is a word which we encounter across many of the software projects and many of the object-oriented programming languages or across many of the databases. So we want to know, what do you mean by this word entity? Okay, now take an example. You want to make a new Bangalore, or you want to construct a new Bangalore. For constructing a new Bangalore, what type of labor, skilled labor or unskilled labor, is required? First, you will search for an architect. So what is this architect? This architect will be known as entity here. You want some civil engineer which will monitor your construction work or the plan, or who will execute the plan which is designed by the architect. So this civil engineer is another entity. Now, to construct your house, to lay down the bricks, you need a mason. This is also one entity. Now, for helping a mason, you need some labor who will supply the bricks and cement to the mason. After this construction work is completed, you need one plumber for do your necessary fittings in the house. You also need an electrician for make necessary electrical arrangements in house. When all this is completed, you also need a painter. You also need a carpenter. So for completing your Bangalore project, you need these type of entities. Like architect, you need civil engineer, you need mason, you need labor, you need one electrician, you need one painter, and you need one carpenter. So these are all the entities which are required for creating your Bangalore. Maybe some another entities like a interior decorator is also an entity may be required. So same is the case with the software development. If you want to design one banking application, for banking application, first you will visualize to what type of entities are required in the banking application. Like one manager will be appointed, teller will be appointed, there will be many clients with the bank, and every client will hold one account in the bank. There will be a one loan section, there will be one credit card section, and there will be one debit card section. So these are all the entities of for the banking application. Now if we compare these entities like architect with our structure, every architect will have some properties. Now what are the properties? Properties like, as an individual, I am having eyes, I am having lips, I am having tongue, I am having some height, I am having some name. So entity should have some properties. Like student is having a property, roll number. Like when an individual becomes a student, these are the properties of the student. So what are the properties? What will be the properties of an architect? Properties of architect is, he is experienced architect. Number of experience, total experience in months or years, whether he owns a B.Arch degree or not. So this is one of the properties. Now also we use our properties like we are an entity. All individuals represent one entity. I represent an entity, you also represent an entity. So all the entities are having some behaviors also. to complete those behaviors, entity use its properties. Like if you are reading a book, you are utilizing the property of I. If you are walking, you are using your property legs. If you are eating, you are utilizing your property mouth. So architect, what are the behaviors of the architect? The behaviors of the architect is that he can construct a house. He can design a house. So what an entity can do is known as a behavior, and what entity already has is known as a property of the entity. Now how the entity achieves this behavior? By using its properties. Like architect can design a house by his experience, and from there he has gained experience by working on many of the projects, and he is able to design a house because he has done a BR degree. Like a mason, mason can design the walls, can design the slabs by using his properties. A labor can supply all the material to the mason by using his properties. He can carry bricks, he can carry cement. A plumber can do the plumbing task. It is a behavior by using its properties. So every entity is representing a complex data structure. Now why this data structure has come into the picture? This data structure has come into the picture, as we know, the data structure is a collection of data. Now like we take the one structure student, what is all this? This is a data, and this is also a collection of data. So every entity is a sort of data structure which is holding some data, like architect is holding this type of data. Now here, if you want to model a real world application like banking application, then we need some more complex data structures. More complex data structure means data structure will definitely hold some data, or data structure will be having some properties, like these are the properties. And data structure should also have the functions to manipulate its properties. Functions to manipulate its properties means the behavior, what the data structure can do. Like now architect is an entity, or we can also say architect is a data structure. He can manipulate, or he can perform the function of building a house by using its properties, experience, and his degree of the architecture. So for completing the function, he has to manipulate his properties. How the properties are get manipulated? Like the experience will be increased, the properties are getting manipulated. For example, if you take this entity account, this account will be having one data that is known as balance. Now this balance can perform two operations. One operation is debit and one operation is credit. These are the two operations which can be performed by an account. Now when the debit function is performed, this function is going to affect the balance, which is the property of the account. And when this credit function will perform or will execute it, it is going to affect the property of the account. Means all the behaviors are done with the help of some property, and they will affect the property somehow. If you run, you will run with the help of your legs. So your property is being utilized by performing the functions. So while designing the application, we have to first target the entities. What are the entities? What will be the entities of our application. Like if you are going to construct a bungalow, these are all the entities which are required. Or if we take an example of software development and you are going to design some banking application, then these are the entities which will be required while designing your banking application. So first target your entities. Like this is one entity, this is second entity, and the third entity. Like if you are making some application for the school, then what are the entities? Principal will be entity, teacher will be entity, student will be entity, result will be entity, attendance will be entity. So many entities are there first. So you have to first monitor the entities, and we can say now that each entity will belong to some class. Now what is a class? A class we can now define. Class is an entity which is having, you can note it down also, which is having some properties and behavior. Now what do you mean by the behavior? The term property is clear to us. Now what do you mean by this behavior? If we take an example of a C language, this behavior will be a function. If we take an example of Java language, these functions are also known as methods. So a behavior means a method. If we talk about the Java language, a behavior is a function. If we talk about the C language, but here we will concentrate on the Java language. In Java language we will design a class. So in class there will be two things. One is properties. Properties means data types. And second thing will be behavior. Behavior means methods. So we can say a class can contain only two things. Yes, this only word is very important here. A class can contain only two things. One is property and second is behavior. Property means data type and behavior means methods. Now here I will use the editor Eclipse. It is the most widely accepted editor for designing any of the project in the core Java, advanced Java, or in for the enterprise Java applications. This is my version, that is Luna. This is Eclipse Luna. So you can also use this editor Eclipse for designing your project or for practicing a small program. So this is a Luna service release 4.4.2. Now how to create or how to run the Java programs using Eclipse? For creating a program in Eclipse, you have to first create project. So file, new. The number of functionalities or number of options are there, you have to search for Java project. If this Java project is not visible to you, go to other and type here Java project. Now it will come visible to you. Now next, you have to then give some name to your project. Like I am giving here the name first project, and then click finish. So this first project is created. SRC folder is used to save all of your Java class files, and this JRE folder contains all the necessary jar files, that is the compiler for Java, interpreter for Java, and all that, as was discussed in tutorial 1. Now we will first create one class to clear our concept which we have discussed here. So in the Eclipse folder, right click on the SRC folder and then new and then class. Now give the name for the class, like the name of the class will be box. Now click finish. As you can see, one class, a empty class, has been created by this Eclipse. So name of the class will be box. So if you have saved your program with the name box.java, it is a convention used in the Java language. It is only a convention, not a necessity, that your class name should start with the capital alphabet. And with whatever name of the file you have mentioned, that name of the file should be exactly same as that of the name of the class. So I have created one class named box. So my Java file name will be box.java. If here I create one class triangle, then the name of the Java file will be triangle.java. And every class name should precede with the word class. So I have created one class and the name of the class is box. Now what's this public word or keyword is doing here? It is an access specifier. Now what are access specifiers? We will discuss in the coming tutorials. Now as we have discussed earlier, a class is having, or a class can contain only two things. One is property. Property means the data type, and the behavior. Behavior means the method. So in our class we will declare three properties of the box. Now what can be the properties of a box? We all know the box is a cubical box, and every cubical box is having or should be having some height. Every cubical box should be having some width. Every cubical box should be having some length. So these will be the three properties of the cubical box. Now here we will design one main method. This is the signature of the main method. The name of the method is main. Void means this method is returning nothing. And what is this public? This is a access specifier. And also we add one word, public static void main. We will, in the coming tutorials, we are going to discuss in detail what do you mean by this static keyword. For a time being, you should write the complete method signature like this. The method signature of the main method, public static void main. Now this take one array of string as a parameter. This we have also already discussed in our tutorial 3 in the command line arguments. Now public static void main, and as a array, it is taking one array of string as a parameter. Now what we are going to do in this class, like we have discussed, a carpenter is a class, or a carpenter is an entity, or a carpenter is a class. If you want to get some wooden work done in your house, then what will you do? You will search for a carpenter, or in a technical language, you will search for an object of class carpenter. Object of class carpenter, it means the carpenter who has come to your house to fulfill your needs is an object of class carpenter. Now by reading the properties and behaviors of class carpenter, you come to know that this is the object which can fulfill my needs, because all the properties and behaviors of the carpenter are specified in the class carpenter. Like if you are having some plumbing time task, like there are a lot of the classes, carpenter class, plumber class, electrician class. You want to get some plumbing work done. You are going to read the definition of the classes, that this is a carpenter class. No, this work cannot be done by the object of this class. Electrician is a class. No, this work cannot be done. So how do you come to know? By reading its properties and behavior. Then you come across one class, that is a plumber. Now you say, now this is the exactly class, or I need the object of this particular class who can do my work. Now while performing the work, object of the class will use the properties, or will use its properties to perform the task. It means a object can manipulate its properties. So first, in this tutorial, we will study how to create the object of class box. It is a very simple syntax. We will write first the class name, then the name of the object, like B. B is the object. Then is equal to new box. I will also let you know in the coming tutorials what do you mean by this long syntax, because each and everything is having a meaning. This new keyword is having a meaning, this is also having a meaning. But just for now, if you want to create object, then class name, then the object name is equal to new keyword, then again class name, and then two braces you have to put here. Now when this line is got executed, one object of class box will be created. Now when this object is created, this object B will be having all of these three properties. Like this object B will be having height, this object B will be having some width, this object B will be having some length. Now this object B, if this object B want to access its properties, it can do it with the help of the dot operator. Now suppose this object B want to manipulate its height, then B dot height or the object name dot height, like it want to assign the value 20 to its height, he can do it with the help of dot operator. This object B wants to assign the value 20 to its width, he can use the dot operator to perform this operation. If this object B wants to assign the value 20 to its length, he can do it with the help of the dot operator. Okay, now this object B wants to calculate the volume. So what is the volume of this box? Then this statement system.out.println, this is a statement to generate the output in the console. What this object is going to do? B dot height multiply by B dot width multiply by B dot length. He will multiply all of these three properties, and we know if we want to find the volume of any cubical object, then we have to multiply its height, width and length. So what the object is doing? Object is multiplying its height, width and length. Okay, now we also generate one message so that we come to know that this is the volume of the object. We will do here system.out.println volume is equal to, and we remove this word ln. Ln means from the new line. Now execute this project. Right click on the class, search for run as, and then run as Java application. A console will appear. Now this volume is equal to 8000. Now this is the volume of object B. Now you are free to create as many objects as you want, respective their name should be different. Like here I have created one new object, the name of the object is B1, and I mention its height as 10 10 10. Now this object wants to print its volume. So volume will be equal to b1 dot height, b1 dot width, and this b1 dot length. Now what will be the volume of this object? The volume of this object will be 1000. Now we run this application, run this Java application, and here the volume is 1000, and the volume of first object B is 8000, and the volume of second object b1 is 1000. So this class is having three properties. Now if we take an example of Java language, what is the memory which is to be claimed by this variable height. It will be of 64 bit, as we know the double takes 64 bits in the memory. But this width 64 bit again, length 64 bit again. So they have to claim 64 bit for height, 64 bit for width, and 64 bit for length in the memory. Or they require 64, 64, and 64 bit of memory. Now, if they ask what will be the memory which is required by this object B. Now, this object B is having three properties of type double. Double means 64 bit. Of type bit, width. Width means 64 bit. And of height means 64 bits. So, 64 plus 64 plus 64, it means 192 bits of memory is required for by the object B. It means the object B is of 192 bits. This object B will be again of 192 bits. Now you are free to create as many objects as per your requirement in your class. There is no limitation on the number of objects which you are going to design in your application. Now, as we have here calculated the volume of this box manually by multiplying its properties, all the three properties, and for this second object B1 by multiplying all its properties, this is not a good programming approach. For if we want to calculate the volume, we should define one behavior. One behavior means one function or one method, as in the Java language, which can calculate the volume. Like architect can design a building, or a civil engineer can execute the plan of the architect. Like the account can be debited, account can be credited. So this is the behavior of our box, that this class box can also calculate or tell its volume to the user, okay, what is my volume. Now this can be done by creating one method. The name of the method will be volume. Now this is the syntax of creating the method in Java language. This method is created within the class. Now the name of the method is volume. This is the method. Then the parenthesis here, where we can specify the parameters. If this method volume is going to take some parameters, but here it is not taking any of the parameters, so this has been left blank. And this is the return type of this method volume. So in the next video of this session, we are going to design this method volume, and we will discuss more about the method. Okay, it's enough for now. If you are having some queries, you can post it to my mail. This is my mail address. Or you can also post your queries or comments in the comment section of this video. Okay guys, good day.